प्यारे सत्संग जी, प्यार से कहिए सतगुरु सतनाम सत साहिब जी, सतगुरु सतनाम सत साहिब जी, सतगुरु सतनाम सत साहिब जी, बोल सतगुरु देव महाराज की जय, सतगुरु देव महाराज की जय, सतगुरु देव महाराज की जय। आज के सत्संग के आनंद की जय, आज के सत्संग के आनंद की जय। टुडे इट इज 28 2020 एंड I am here before all the Hansas of Trilok, Paramahansas of Amarlok, and Satpurushji of Amarlok. I bow my head before Satpurushji for his benediction, love, and grace, and to make me to give his message to the whole universe, including Satlok, and I should act as a mic of that very voice. That sort of blessing should be given to me by your good self. So today my topic is Maya is a mind. How Maya is a mind? How Maya is a mind is today's topic of mine. So, soul presents glimpse of Satpurush. All the Hansas present in these three lobes, whether on earth, bitter lobe, seven heavens, Sun, Mahasun, Sheshastra Sar, all are the segments of Satpurush. They have nothing to do with these three lobes. They are in bondage. He is a segment of love, honesty, truth, joy, and peace. So, Hansa doesn't possess any quality of the mind or any quality of the Maya. It is free of all amalgamation of baser elements, ego, jealousy, treachery, decayity, superstitions. All the baser elements have been infused in Surati by the mind and Maya. So this mind makes Surati to move in yesterday and tomorrow. It never makes it to remain in the present, because that is not the quality of mind and Maya. Their quality is to shift and toss mind with Surati in past and future. So, quality of Surati is always to be in the present, but he is being tossed in the past and future. To develop the qualities of mind and Maya in Surati, because body is an organ with whom this Surati has been living for lakhs and lakhs of births. So it has become habitual to consider itself as body. So any order that comes from mind, from intellect, that is being executed by Surati. I have already mentioned that mind and Maya itself can't do anything. They simply infuse thoughts, wishes, desires in the Surati, in the body, and Surati takes up as it is to itself. Surati takes that this decision has been given to him and not to the body, because he has considered itself as body, that every body on this planet consider himself as body. When you say, I do this, I do that, I act like this, I act like that, who is acting? Actually, it is the body who is acting. You are not acting and you are not a body. Body is a composition of five elements. And your qualities are quite different. You are truth. You are love. You are joy. You are peace. So from where this comes, other baser elements like ego, jealousy, lust, pleasure. Pleasure is the organ. Happiness is the organ of mind, but pleasure is the joy. Pleasure is the segment of Surti. Happiness is the segment of mind. I agree to this. So, one is always tossed from one segment to another. And see the quality of Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord has love for all and hatred for none. He has no mind, no five elements, so nobody. He doesn't possess anybody. No mind, no life and death cycle. So Amara Lok is free from all these segments. That is, there is no mind, there are no five elements, there is no life and death cycle. It is pure love, joy, anand, peace, truth. So, Hansa is a segment of Satpurush. So all those qualities that are being possessed by Satpurush lie in Hansa. So from where these all baser thoughts, ideas and wishes, desires have cropped up, they are infused by mind and Maya into the body, and Hansa takes it as his own. And it is because of this very reason the whole world is in dilemma. The whole world speaks in terms of mind. Everybody say, clean your mind. Who can you clean your mind? Mind is very strong. And little mind sitting in you and cosmic mind is outside. So you are not mind. And so you say, clean your mind. This is the tragedy of all the human beings on this planet. They have not realized themselves. They are not true about themselves. Your elevation, your progress, your development is not the outcome of the outer world. It is the outcome of within. You are as great as Amara Lok is. You are as great as this cosmic three loks are. All reside well within your body. So where to go? We have to make progress in to out, not out to in. So the world is going out to in. That is the tragedy. Whereas it should have to move in to out. Spiritualism first and worldly progress next. And we say worldly progress first and spiritualism is almost dead. It is not next but dead. The moment you remain in the domain of mind and maya, the spiritualism is gone. It doesn't exist. People are not interested in spiritual knowledge, but only spiritual in dress, way of walking, living, eating and doing worship place and going to worship places. For what purpose? Making others to have his presence. Great personalities of the external world are present there. So he too has to go there to show his presence at religious places, at congregations. You gather, you celebrate, you do whatsoever you like. But it is simply external extravaganza. It is external show. It is not worship. Worship should be well from the core of your surti, not heart. Everyone on this planet has talked about you, about the heart. Even Kabir sir, he has talked lot and lot about mind. He has forgotten about surti. But my objective is to take you to towards surti, to your own real self. You are hansa. Hansa means surti. Hansa means combination of surti and nirti. Surti is in your heart and nirti is in your breath. In every inhaling it comes and in every exhaling it goes. You are dying each and every moment and you are given birth in the next moment. Every moment you get life and in every moment you get death. So we are seeing this process well within our breath. When breath is in, we get life. When the breath is thrown out, we are dead. But this process is in quick succession and we don't realize that we are born and dead. We are born and dead. Unlimited, uncountable times in our life. So my preaching is not my preaching. It is all from the side of Satpurush. So Satpurush neither gains victory nor gets defeated. On this planet, you saw in Dwapar a fight between Kauravas and Pandavas. And Krishnaji, Lord Krishna was a witness to it. Rather a participant in it. But such like things don't exist in Sat alone. These exist on this planet because of mind and maya. Every country who becomes superpower or next to superpower, they try to establish their authority on others. So, in order to keep the balance, all other countries do have to have the forces, have the borders. So one has to safeguard the country, and that's a must. When country is safe, you are safe. When you are safe, you can move in and out. But when tragedy arises, everything goes. So, in this world, soul surti finds itself helpless. Soul is not allowed to function from life till death. And nobody talks about soul. All 60 lakh gurus, they are the representatives of Karl Narendra. So they are giving the same thing as they have been given by their predecessors. And they talk only about mind. Clean your mind. Do this, do this. Who will do? Only a power bigger than what you are facing. Then and then you can do anything. When you are not an authority, mind is very strong. And two minds, one segment is sitting inside your Sushumna and other in the whole cosmos. So with whom you will fight to make your body clean? Whereas body itself is the segment of Maya. And man and Maya both are the one and the same thing. So this body is a composition of five elements. Each human body is made up of Maya. That's creation of mind. Every body which is a composition of five elements is a Maya. Maya, that means creation of mind. Maya is a creation of mind. Both are the same thing. And this Maya has been divided into three segments. It has three shapes: Satgun, Rajgun, and Tamgun. As per the behavior of the mind within you. And that too depends upon your Surti. At the time of birth, you get something of your seven ancestral pedis, your seven ancestral carry the message in your body. So if they remain religious, well within, whatsoever they developed in the body, that is being transferred to you. So you represent seven generations. Any newborn baby have the characteristics of seven generations in him. So all those characters are imbibed from those ancestors. So according to that, he will act. Either he is Satoguni, Rajoguni, or Tamoguni. Some are achieved and some are acquired. The family in which you have come, that too has a great impact on you. And you will be made to act according to their religious ways of living, thinking, doing, eating, behaving, and you will be directed to move on those very directions. Whereas I lay a stress that newborn baby should be given education, should be given food, should be given clothing, but he should not be given a religious education. Let him live up to 16 years, and after that, when he is in a position to realize Vedan, his intellectual position is sound, he can decide about his own self. Whether he has to show outer religion, whether he has to move within, whether he has to progress outwardly or whether he has to progress inward. Because if you start at the very outset, at the infancy level, then you have molded the mind of that personality. And no, it can't be reverted back. Very difficult to revert him back. Then whole work of the nature is gone. So we are working especially against our own father, Satpurush. And we are acting as per the direction of mind and maya, which have got no relation with our Surati. We are not the segment of mind, so we are not the segment of this God at all. We are not with the baser elements of desires and wishes, so we are free from maya, but we have imbibed all these qualities from our parents, from our ancestors. This is the tragedy. This is the thing which never allows anybody to realize his own self, to be in the present. Don't worry whatsoever is happening. All will be okay if you will remain steadfast on your basic principles of truth, love, joy, and peace. But the things are going in the wrong direction. I had elaborated an example of sea day before, and I had taken the example of sea, that sattvic quality is just like the quality of a drop or layer of drops well within the base of the sea, hundreds of fathom deep inside the sea. How much weight he is carrying, how much pure it is, how silent he is, how much love he possesses to carry so many drops over his body. And he is not making any human cry. And nobody can save him. I gave the example of mountains. Say, take the case of Himalaya. The atoms, every universe, everything is a union of atoms, the molecules, and then compounds and like it, this and that. And see the condition of those very atoms which are lying at the bottom of the mountain, Mount Everest. They are bearing the burden, the palms of their ancestors, they are lying above them. But nobody is taking care of those very things. They are responsible to uphold these mountains. Those drops which lie below the sea, they are upholding the oceans. So everything has to be realized. One who is holding all these things can be called as Sattvic. Sattvic means truth. Sattvic means love. Sattvic means joy. Sattvic means peace. And see all these things. Do everything with peace. They don't cry. Don't make any ruler cry. They are bearing all the burden. They are bearing all the tortures. So, Sattvic gradient in the present world is nowhere to be found, so far as human beings are concerned. It is there in the inanimate, but it is not there where there is life. There is quite contradiction, no acceptance, rejection and rejection. So, I don't find that this Satguna is any longer the segment of mind and maya. This is a segment of Shruti. When you, I see the drop that is living at the bottom is always in the present. You also can attain that very position through Shruti concentration. You too can go at the bottom. And all those qualities that you visualize, that are being faced by the drops at the sea level, you will attain the same well within you as I attain. That's why I'm speaking on these topics. Same is the case with the small atoms, small molecules lying well below the Mount Everest. They are upholding mountains and mountains on their shoulders, on their body. See the power of atoms. That is why I say this Shruti well within you is very powerful. It is more powerful than an atom. That is why your Shruti can do miracles well within your body. If an atom outside can perform wonders, why can't you well within? See the case up here. The layer up there which is at the bottom is bearing the burden of all the layers of the air above it. And when that pressure exceeds, you see raindrops. So everything is functioning accordingly to these three segments, Satgun, Rajgun and Tamgun. So in this world, that is in this living world, the segment of Satgun is not existing at all. Satgun is only if he is, or if people consider, is Satgun, who bears all these things well within himself. And he can be considered as Sattvic. So Sattvic in the present way of living can't be considered as the segment of mind or maya. It is a segment of Shruti. Secondly, there was a period at the time of annihilation of this universe, at the making of the universe, after the exhalation, annihilation is a must. After destruction, construction is a must. So, when life first came on the planet, that is known as Satyug. Satyug means Satvik. So they were all satvik in nature. There was no rajas, nor tamoguni. So only satvik personalities were there on the planet. And all those who are present in Sun, Mahasun, Shashatra Sa, and in the first three heavens, first, second, and third, they turned themselves into 75 to 99% Shruti concentration. They got themselves concentrated up to that very level. Just like Goroknath attained his Shruti concentration of 75%. Vedvyasji concentrated his Shruti up to 90%. Sukhdevji concentrated his Shruti up to 95%. Raja Janak 98%. And this Venam who is sitting before you at first attained 99%. As the percentage of God called Narinjan himself. They are also in this universe. Only when you cross 100, you attain the stage of 100, you can be called Hansa. Till then you are not Hansa. Till then you are Yogeshwar. At the stage of 99, because God himself is up to the level of 99. So you can reach up to his level of concentration. And the moment you demand anything or get any wish, he is ready to satisfy you. And then you become a slave and go according to your Shruti concentration into that very low. If 99, you will go into Sahasra Sarva. So, my whole lectures on this planet are the outcome of Satpurush himself. It is he who is giving you this all, whereas I am merely a speck, merely a representative, merely a mic to put forth his Shruti concentration before you through words, because he doesn't possess these words. He possesses Shruti, and I possess both Shruti and words. So I translate his Shruti into words. My objective is to translate his Shruti into words and give it to you, because you understand only the language of words, not of Shruti at present. But you can, when you will become Satvik, you will move towards Satvik, you can have this quality. So it is not difficult, but you have to move inward. Outwardly, you can't have these very qualities in you. That is why I said, the quality, if you attain the position of first 75%, you will meet those personalities who attain concentration of Shruti 75%. They will come to meet you because you are of the same rank. And when you will attain 90%, all those personalities, those who have attained that very stage of concentration, they will come to meet you. And when you attain the stage of 98, naturally those who have attained that very stage, they will get exalted. They will become very happy. They will see, oh, this too has come in our category. Just like this is meet, secretary meet, minister meet. They behave in the same way. They respect each other. They embrace each other. Because they are of the same in nature. They are of the same in level. And when a prime minister of another country comes into another country. Both the prime ministers, because they consider themselves equal, shake hands, embrace each other. Like begets love. Attain that very position and you will get them with you. They will be with you. You can call them at any moment. They are ready to meet you. Everybody has met me in every stage. Only a person who has undergone these processes can explain. Whatsoever I am giving on this planet is all new. This has not been known to anyone because they have not seen these. They have not visited such lokas. They have not met with such personalities. They have met in external personalities, not the internal. One who will move internally, he will meet with the internal personality. One is moving outside and making progress outwardly, he will meet with the external personalities. But with the external personalities, you can't gain anything regarding your spiritualism. You will be treated at the time of death as an ordinary person. Because they won't recognize you. You have not maintained your position according to them. So who will recognize you? You will be thrown in that very region where there is no connection of Surti. You have not made any progress regarding Surti. So you always talk about mind, 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 mind. So you will go into the loka of mind. Hells are meant for the same thing. Atmic lokas, where the ghosts go, that loka, that is very big. I have seen that also. I have seen their worries and woes also. So, it is not the meeting with anybody, you have to become like that. And you will meet. A DC, when will you say to another DC, okay, they will meet like anything. A secretary, when meet secretary, a doctor will say to doctor, a lawyer will meet with a doctor, but he will see what quality lawyer he is. Is he a lawyer of lower court, is he a lawyer of high court, is he a lawyer of supreme court. According to the level, they will embrace each other. They will shake hands with each other. The same is the case with the spiritualism. So one can meet any personality while attaining that very position well within yourself. I went on making progress and went on meeting those personalities and went on ahead. They departed, the others who were up to 75, they departed from. Then I moved ahead, then I reached to 90. Then those who were in the concentration of 90, they came before me. We met with each other. Then, so on. And at the end, when I attained the stage of 99, then God Himself came along with Satpurush. Because I never demanded anything, he tries his level best that he should wish for anything and I should fulfill him to make him as my slave. But I never demanded anything. That's why I say to anybody, don't demand anything from God and goddesses. Then you will become a permanent slave of theirs. Try to save yourself from the slavery of these personalities. They are going to put you in a ditch. When you demand anything, you have fallen into the ditch. You have gone far and far away from reality. Now, whatsoever you earned, it went into the dustbin. So that is my first and foremost lesson to every individual, every creature, every human being on this planet. Please don't demand anything from any spiritual authority. Let he be Satpurush. I am not demanding anything even from Satpurush for my own self. But I do demand for others, for my countrymen, for the world at large, but never for my own self, for my own safety, for my own progress. Nothing of this sort. So, my humble request to you all is, these gunas are there. See the surface of sea. How polluted it is at present. So many water dwellers are dying day by day. They are not finding place to lay their eggs for the new generation to come. This plastic material has created havoc in the whole of the universe. It has become a source of destruction of the world. This plastic material is ruining the basic life on the planet. You may damp it anywhere, but ultimately it reaches to the sea. Sea is the main place for every dirt and rubbish. It reaches there. We don't make that, it won't go into the sea. But if anything is being made, finally it will go into the sea. So this is the condition of the top surface of water. It is always being tossed. It is always put in trouble. It has to face all the woes and worries of the society. So Tamasic has to suffer a lot in this present world. See the condition of the poor during this 19 COVID. They were the main sufferers on this planet. They were moving from pillar to post, without job, without money, without food. Their children are suffering. Though the society is helping them a lot, but still, when you don't have of your own, you can't be satisfied. As a beggar, you can't live happy even for a few days. You can live happily for a few hours, and that too you have to spend a time lot and lot for that very package of food. So Tamasic people are the main sufferers in the whole of the universe. They bear the burnt of nature. They bear the burnt of the society. They bear the burnt of their own self. So how they can be uplifted inwardly? They can't be made to move anywhere. Their life is so miserable, so pitiable, so disgraceful. Their children cry, where we are? I have seen this period in my life, that is why I am telling. I have seen. Up to the age of 24, I suffered a lot. Certain things are not to be disclosed. There is no use to tell you, but I suffer. So my dear friends, only Rajas people are satisfying their lust on this planet. They are very clever. They have the qualities of cunningness like a fox. They see the trend and move accordingly. They can become religious at a time. They can become atheist at a time. They become politician at a time. They become religious person at a time. According to the situation, they are everything. They are not stagnant. They are flexible. They can be made to move anywhere. They can join one party to another within seconds, within minutes. So, very few are, I should say, lying. Sattvic is purely a Paramhansa. Satguru is Sattvic. Otherwise, no one else. So he doesn't come under the category of mind and maya. So it has wrongly been put in the field of mind and maya. Only two qualities can be in the field of maya and mind. That is rajas and tamasic. I said during the period of Satyug, all the great personalities who had attained and those who have attained the stage of 99% concentration, they take birth on the planet. And because of that, they live in peace. It is because of their concentration, they keep their doors open. Nobody is there to steal anything. Nobody is going to abuse anybody. Nobody is going to harm anybody. All things started onwards. When the other type of person, Rajas and Tamasic, also took birth, then the whole problem got in the worsen stage. And these things went on, and that is, this Kali Yuga is the stage where it is in the culmination. Exhalation has to take. Know the time. Almost 60% time is over. Less than 40% time is left for its exhalation, for its destruction. That's why Kali Yuga is the most crucial period on the planet, in which only tamasic persons flourish, live, guide, become everything on the planet. They are having everything of the planet in their hands. It is not the question of one country, two countries, in every country. Rich will rule. Well-educated will rule. Those who possess money, they will rule. Those who have high position in the society will rule. So, Satoguni will be far, far behind. That is why consider them sitting in the Himalaya, or on the top of the Himalaya, or at the bottom of the Himalaya. And tamasic are the people who are put in trouble from all corners, from all sides, from all nook and corner. They are being tossed as people, as the souls were tossed in the hell. They are treated in the same way as tamasic people are being treated in the whole world. So, when these things happen, destruction is not far off. The destruction is at your door now. It has not entered into your house, but it is approaching. It is approaching towards your door, but you are not aware of that. So, I am giving an alarm to the whole society and telling you the truth, that Rajas is most active, most cunning, most clever, most energetic, most mindful, most mayavi. So he has all those qualities that are possessed by mind and maya. When everywhere this rajas is prevailing, where will go sattvic personality 1, 2, 3, 4, 10? They can be counted on fingers. Sattvic personalities in Kali Yuga can be counted on fingers. And rajas are uncountable. They have no religion, no caste, no creed. Only money is their religion. Position is their religion. Position and money, these are the two things that are in their hands. And they make via media of adjusting their kids as well. They have their sources, they adjust one way or the other. If not in public, be in the private, because they have enough money with them to put their kids in business. And business too is being run when you are sown from all sides. But they are not sown in spiritualism, but they are very much present there. They are the leaders over there also. They are the main source of running those very institutions also. They are everything. This is the quality of the Thomas. And Thomas Gun is for the behavior of mind and body. And their concentration level of Surti is very low. When the man and mind will go on departing, your concentration of Surti will go on increasing. But when you move away from the inner self to the outer self, the inner concentration of Surti will go on decreasing and the external world will go on increasing. You have to become 100. If you have internal only 5%, 95% you will be of mind. You are rajas. And you can be full masses within no time. Rajas has everything within. He utilizes, he makes use of all types of things which are well within his possession. He is not afraid of anybody. He knows how to get himself extracted from any problem. So, God Vishnu is the representative of Satagun. Brahma Ji is a representative of Rajasgun. And Shivji is the representative of Tamogun. All these three devatas are taking care of them. And from my lecture, can you recognize that they are taking care of? Can you visualize they are taking care of if they are devatas? Devatas' duty is to keep everything in balance. But when you are full of mind, what sort of violence? Then there is a bias everywhere. These devatas are equal in quality, equal in concentration. Then why the difference is there in the universe? What is the reason behind it? You must think over it. And in my coming lectures, I will explain that also. So, these three types of persons, sattvic personalities, simply a Satguru who comes on the planet is sattvic, because he bears the burden of everyone and he remains ready. He puts his soul on his hands and move him. That is my condition. I have no relation with the external world at all. Not even the least. Not even 1%. All the relations, everything is away from. I am living in the internal world and giving you everything from the internal world to the outer world. So it is up to you to see what you want. So that is why I say nobody in the present can be found to move towards spiritualism. Spiritualism is not an external thing. It is not the quality of mind and maya. It is the quality of surti. The moment you realize that we are surti, and we have to realize themselves, and we have to live in the present, then and then, this concentration of surti will establish itself in the universe. Otherwise, it is a dead thing. It is zero. And I explain.